This data interpretation question has been taken from SBI PO mains 2017 exam. It is memory based. People have reported to me that this question was asked. So let us see what this question is. This pie chart, it shows distance covered upstream. Total distance 1800 km was traveled. Sunday 18%, Monday 15%, then like that. The percentage traveled has been given in the form of a pie chart. Similarly, the distance covered downstream, it is total distance of 1500 km and week day wise percentage is given to us. So distance is covered, and here day wise table of stream speed is also given. On Monday the speed was at 2 km per hour, Tuesday 3, Wednesday he hasn't given us anything about it. Thursday, Friday, Saturday nothing, Sunday 4 km per hour. One thing that we can see is that the total distance is in kilometers and the speed is also in kilometers per hour. Mostly we are not required to do conversions in this case. Let us take the questions one by one. If the time taken by boat to travel upstream on Thursday is equal to the time taken by it to travel downstream on Monday, and the speed of boat in still water on Monday is 16 km per hour, then find the speed of boat in still water on Thursday. So this is basically about timings, nothing else. Time taken by boat to travel upstream on Thursday. Upstream, this is the upstream part. On Thursday, the distance traveled is 12%. 12% of 1800. 12% of 1800, 12 by 100 into 1800 means the total distance is 12 into 18. Simply the product of this figure and 18. So keeping this in mind, we have the time taken to travel upstream on Thursday. The time will be distance by speed. Distance on Thursday is 12. Multiplied by 18. 12 multiplied by 18, this is the distance, divided by the speed on Thursday. What is the speed on Thursday? The boat speed in still water has to be found out. Let that speed be x, and this is upstream. Subtract the speed of stream, which is 1 kilometers per hour. This will be the net speed, the upstream. This is the total time upstream. It is given equal to the time taken to travel downstream on Monday. What is the distance downstream on Monday? Monday is this one, 16% of 1500. We can write directly 16 into 15. Because that percent and this 100 will cancel out. Divide it by the total downstream speed on Monday. The speed of boat in still water is 16. And the speed of stream is 2 on Monday. This will be the sum. Because downstream speed is the sum and the upstream speed is the difference. You should revise your boats and streams, those simple theories. That is, the net upstream speed is the difference of the speed of boat in still water and the speed of the stream, and downstream speed is the total. And this is now to be solved for x. What we will do is, we'll just quickly write it off. X should be equal to 18 into 18 into 12. 12 into 18 into 18. Divided by 16 into 15, and this plus 1 will go that way. I have quickly written it, and this now needs to be simplified. 4 4 43 35 22 29. Now this is 10, so I'll multiply them. 9 8 72 162 16.2. This 10 makes 16.2 plus 1 is equal to 17.2 kilometers per hour, which is the required answer in this case. Let us move to the next question now. If the time taken by boat to travel upstream on Monday, okay, let's write the figures for Monday. Upstream is Monday, this one is 15%. So time will be distance 15 multiplied by 18. As usual, the percentage cancels with the 1800. Distance divided by the speed on Monday. The speed on Monday in still water, let the boat speed be X. You see, this is the required speed. Find the speed of boat in still water on Monday. Minus the speed of stream 2. This is given equal to 45 by 11 multiplied by, no, more. 45 by 11 more. So this means you'll have to add. This is plus the time taken by to travel downstream on the same day. So we'll add it. Downstream time is the distance downstream, which is 15 into 16 divided by the speed downstream. The speed downstream on Monday would be X is the speed in still water that we have to find out. To this, let us add 2. So basically, we have to solve this equation for X. The best option would be to try guess here. Instead of solving this one, try to make an intelligent guess. 22 minus 2 will give me 20, and here I will get 24. I'll have to take care of this 11. Try to find some multiple of this 11 first of all. So 18 minus 2 is 16. 18 plus 2 is 20. No scope. 20 seems to be a probable possibility, because 20 plus 2 is 22, and I can have some commonality with this 11, and 18 will get cancelled here. So I'll try this 20. Put 15 into 18 by 20 minus 2. This is equal to 15, the left hand side. Let us try for the right hand side. 45 by 11 plus 15 into 16 by 22. Cancel it. 2 11 2 8, which is equal to, now you can take 15 into 3 is 45. 15 by 11 can be taken common, multiplied by, this will be 3 plus 8, and you can see 8 plus 3 is 11. This will get cancelled out, so I will have 15 on the right hand side, and my guess shows that 20 is indeed the correct answer. Let's move to the next question now. If the speed of boat in still water on Tuesday, boat in still water was 15 kilometers per hour, and the speed of boat in still water on Wednesday was 66.2/3% more than that of Tuesday. So let's write first of all, the speed of boat in still water on Tuesday is given equal to 15, and on Wednesday, I'll write on Wednesday, it is 66.2/3% more. So you can see this one will be 66 into 3 is 198 plus 200 by 3% more. That is So I'll not skip the steps. It will be 15, the speed on Tuesday, plus the speed on Tuesday into 200/3%. You see, this 66 2 by 3 is 200/3, and in terms of percent, I'll have to divide by 100. So this speed comes to 00 cancel, 5 10 25. So I have the speeds on Tuesday and Wednesday, and time taken to travel upstream on Wednesday is 9/10 times the time taken by it to travel downstream. Then find the speed of stream on Wednesday. So let the speed on stream or speed of stream on Wednesday be, let us suppose, x. Now let us set up the equation. Time taken to travel upstream on Wednesday. On Wednesday, upstream, come this side. The distance is green one, 14 into 18. We have 14 into 18 distance divided by the speed on Wednesday, upstream. Speed of stream is not known, let it be x. So it will be subtracted from the speed of stream, speed of boat, which is 25. This is equal to 9/10 times the time taken by to travel downstream on Tuesday. Distance downstream on Tuesday, this is downstream. Tuesday is orange, 14 into 15 divided by the speed on downstream, speed on Tuesday. The speed of boat is 15. To this, let us add the speed of the stream on Tuesday, which is 3. We have to solve this equation for x. You can check it out yourself. This 9 and this 18 will cancel on 2. Then we have 14 here. This 14 gets cancelled on both the sides. And now I will do one thing. I'll try to cancel off these 5, 3, 5, 2. And this 3 will cancel this on 6. So orally also you can see this is 4. 24 goes to that side, which implies 24 is equal to 25 minus x comes this side. Therefore, x should be equal to 1, which is the required 1 kilometers per hour, which is the required answer. Let us move to the next question now. The speed of boat in still water on Saturday was 21 kilometers per hour. We'll write boat still water on Saturday. On Saturday was equal to 21 kilometers per hour. And that on Sunday was 28 4/7%. What is 28 4/7%? This is equal to 28 into 7 plus 4/7%. So this is 196 plus 4, 200/7%, which is equal to 2/7. Okay, now he says 28 on Sunday was, I'll write Sunday, it was 2/7 less than that on Saturday. So we can say on Sunday the speed was 21 minus 2/7 into 21, which is equal to 15 kilometers per hour. So we have the speeds on Saturday and Sunday with us. If the time taken by boat to travel upstream on Saturday is 1 3/16 times the time taken to travel downstream on Sunday, then find the time taken by the boat to cover a distance of this much upstream when the speed of stream is same that on Saturday. To solve this question, let us do one thing. We'll we have to find the time taken by to travel distance upstream on Saturday. We have to take the time taken to cover this much distance on Saturday upstream. So let us try to make use of this fact first. He says, time taken by boat to travel upstream on Saturday. So let's write it. Upstream time on Saturday is given equal to 1/3/16. Let us simplify this also. This you can see is 19/16. Mixed fraction 16 plus 3 by 16, which is 19/16. It is 19/16 times the time taken to travel downstream on Sunday. What time does it take on downstream on Sunday? This is downstream. Sunday is blue. Distance traveled is 15 into 10. And what was the Sunday? The speed of boat was 15. And the speed of stream was 4, so it will be 15 plus 4. This is what it would be. I can see 19 and 19 cancel out, and I'll try some cancellation on 16 also. 2, 8, 2, 5. So 75/8 hours. The upstream time on Saturday. This time is for how much distance? Saturday, this one 10%, that is 18 into 10. So 180 kilometers. Time is 75/8. And by unitary, for 57.6 would be 75/8, this 18 into 10 comes down, into 1/18 into 10, multiplied by 57.6, 576/10. We can perform cancellations. This cancels on 32. And this 8 cancels on 4. So what do we have left with this? 75 into 4 by 100. 10 into 10 is 100. 75 into 4 is what? 300. 300 by 100 is 3. Therefore, we can say this is equal to 3 hours, which is the required answer. If the time taken by boat to travel upstream on Sunday is 2 hours more than the time taken by it to travel downstream on Thursday, and the speed of boat in still water on Thursday is 17, then find the upstream speed of the boat on Sunday. Let us set up the basic equation. Time taken by boat to travel upstream on Sunday is 2 hours more. So on upstream on Sunday it travels this much distance, 18 into 18, 18% and 18. And what was the speed on Sunday? Upstream speed of the boat on Sunday is required. This is the upstream speed that is required. That means this is the net speed. Now this is very important. He is not asking the speed of boat in still water or of the stream. He is asking the net speed. So let me write it as x. This is equal to 2 hours more, 2 plus time taken by it to travel downstream on Thursday. Thursday downstream distance was 12 into 15. This was the distance, divided by The speed on Thursday? The speed of stream was 1. 1 will be added to the speed of boat in still water on Thursday, 17. So this is the equation that has to be solved. This is 18. 6, 3, 18. 6, 2, 12. 3, 5, 15. So this becomes equal to 5 into 2, 10 plus 2, 12. And therefore x should be equal to 18 into 18 divided by 12. This 12 goes down. 6, 2, 6, 3, 2, 9, which is equal to 27 kilometers per hour, which is the required answer. So this is how we could solve these questions.